This is the Audi e-tron, otherwise known as the brand's first ever fully electric production car. That's right, there's no engine, no range extender, it's electric all the way, and gives you a taster of what Audi's future model lineup will look like. Built on an all-new dedicated electric vehicle platform, the e-tron's sizable proportions mean it slots in between the brand's Q5 and Q7 models. Future variants of the e-tron are planned, with a Sportback and GT Sport Saloon set to follow. Rivals of the e-tron include the pioneering Tesla Model X, as well as more recent additions to the electric SUV list, such as the Mercedes-Benz EQC and Jaguar I-Pace. Keep watching to find out why we think the e-tron should definitely be on your list if you're looking for a luxury SUV EV. Climb inside the cabin and the e-tron's interior is very similar to what you get with other Audis such as the A8 and Q7. That means lots of expensive materials, lots of screens and a general feeling that you've got your money's worth. In fact, the most notable feature on display is undoubtedly the wing mirrors, or rather, the lack of if you spec their 21st century equivalent. See, the e-tron gives you the option to remove the conventional mirrors and instead have small cameras positioned on the outside of the car. The resulting picture is then transmitted to two screens that are just above the interior door handles on each side. Sounds good in theory, but in reality, they're actually very hard to get used to and not as good as the regular mirrors. Trim levels at the time of filming include Technic, Sport, S-Line, e-tron and Launch Edition, the latter coming with unique Audi Sport alloys and black exterior trim details. All models though come with lots of standard equipment, such as Audi Virtual Cockpit, the MMI Navigation Plus infotainment system, a rear view camera and adaptive air suspension. On to practicality, and because the e-tron has its batteries stored under the floor, space in the cabin is generous, meaning you should be able to get 2 6-foot passengers in the back without any trouble at all. Just be aware that the middle seat is quite narrow, and unlike the Tesla Model X, there's no 7-seat option in the e-tron. Boot space, meanwhile, is larger than both the Jaguar I-Pace and Mercedes-Benz EQC at 605 litres. There's also underfloor storage and 40-20-40 folding seats as standard, something you don't get in the Jaguar. And because there's no engine, you'll find a small storage compartment under the bonnet. Out on the road, the e-tron is just like any other Audi SUV in that you can have it with varying amounts of power. There's the 50 Quattro that has 312 horsepower and accelerates from 0 to 62 miles an hour in 6.8 seconds, and there's the 55 Quattro that boasts 408 horsepower and 0 to 62 miles an hour in 5.7 seconds with the boost mode activated. Range is slightly less than rivals at 248 and 186 miles for the 55 and 50 Quattro models respectively, while charging time is around 30 minutes for an 80% refill using a 150 kilowatt fast charger. This translates to an 8 to 9 hour charging time using an 11 kilowatt home charger. All-round comfort is excellent, with the air suspension delivering a cosseting ride and the lack of engine noise making for a serene environment. What's more, handling is surprisingly good for a car that weighs in at 2.5 tons. Overall, the Audi e-tron offers a super luxurious way to travel around on electric power alone. The only sticking point is if you insist on having the most amount of range possible, in which case the e-tron's rivals look better on paper. Don't forget that if you're looking to buy or lease an Audi e-tron, then be sure to check out the relevant tabs above the main review page on our website, where you can browse through literally hundreds of excellent deals.